Welcome to Cousins Chaos News. Today we have two new people joining us.
We have our neighbors, Bailey and Scarlett.
Also known as Kaylee and Garlic. Would you like to say a few words to us?
Yes.
Here you go.
I'm Garlic and I like potatoes.
Howdy.
I'm Kaylee.
And Evie has some very important news regarding the Cousins Chaos today.
As you can see, we aren't in our normal place because we have a new building.
It's a 9-foot high elevation with an 11-by-11 floor and has absolutely no AC, so we're going to be sweating all this video. And today, we're going to give y'all, as said, Cece,
a tour! Yay!
All right. So, as you can see, we have a crazy man dancing up on our new headquarters, a basketball court, a new front porch, a pole to slide down, and as you can see in here, this is where we store our vehicles and working supplies. So we are going, and that right there is where we store our wooden weapons. Don't know why we have them, we just have them. Now, as you can see, we got stairs, which we still will be working on. Oh, yeah, that's the bridge.
No.
It's not called the Bridge of Terror Bestia because it's not sad. That here's the bridge. Here's the steps. We go up.
Wait, are you saying tomato or potato?
All right, y'all guys gotta be quiet. Sorry. As you can see, we got the back porch with the couch and the guys who are tucking around and some work and plus some work areas. Let's go inside.
Tortilla.
Say hey, Curtis.
Tortilla. Is it syrup or syrup?
On the inside, we have our bow wall.
No, it's
this is where the couch usually should go, but we had to move it out because it's burning up in here. Here's a table. We got a chest right here for our stuff. We got a shooting dummy. And we got a mailbox. And we got a blackboard. And out there, oh yeah, we got a steering wheel right here. And out there, we got our roof that we can stand on.
Hello, breaking news.
Local Florida man thinks he's a bug.
The question is though, is he crazy or is he my brother?
Roll the clip.
Insurance covered that.
Well, today we have a guest with us. Evie, can you introduce us to him?
We have Hutch, the NASA expert, here to share about some new prototypes he has come up with.
Today, I have hand-selected Cousin Chaos people to watch the shooting, the launching of the new prototype rockets, the Bobcats.
These look like very interesting rockets, sir.
They're prototypes, so they are interesting.
Were they very expensive?
Yes. How expensive do you think rocket fueling rockets are?
Somewhere around 1.5 million, maybe, I assume.
That is pretty expensive. Yeah, that's where I say.
You don't know, do you?
No, I do not. I had a multimillionaire pay for all this stuff.
Well, there you have it, folks. We have a prototype launching coming up next.
3, 2, 1. We have liftoff.
Oh my goodness! No.
Oh, great.
We'll fix that in post.
Well, that was interesting. Can't wait for the manned flight. Anyway, we have a special guest with us today, Evie.
Here with me, I have Gag, a professional drone flyer.
Hello today, you people of the world. Today, gotta fix my mustache. Today, in honor of the Indy 500, we'll have a drone race. Me versus your best pilot. Even though Gage Galloway is not here because he is by far the best pilot. My mustache fell off. No. Sorry, I'm a bit sweaty in this jacket.
I have a question for you. Where'd you get your jacket?
I won it because I won the Indy 500 once.
I could have sworn I saw that same jacket in Walmart one time.
Well, then you'd be lying because I'm totally not a cheapskate and a fake. Anyway.
I think his accent changed.
Okay,
they were selling the British accent for 50% off. What's up over there?
Okay, well, we're gonna go watch this Indy Drone 500 thingy-ma-bob, and we're gonna have to go meet the contestants. Gag, will you be participating in it this year?
I will be there to destroy whoever's against me, and not in the evil villain way.
I can't wait.
Good luck. Well, see you though. We are here with the person behind the scenes on everything that is doing here today. This person set up everything and all the drones. Who are you?
Hutch Galloway.
So what exactly did you do?
I just plugged up the drones with the batteries, which took a lot of work. I had to turn on the drones and the remote, and I had to set them up right, which is hard work.
I bet. And are you going to be racing today?
No.
Well, they couldn't race without you, so good job, man.
Hello, we are here with another racer. So who are you?
Okay, and
okay. I wasn't informed.
Oh, okay, you weren't informed. Well, are you excited about the race?
Yes.
Good. Do you think you're gonna win?
No, I don't.
Okay, well, great confidence. Good luck.
Hello, we are back with Gag. So, hello, are you excited about the race?
Not really. It's going to be a show on if you ask me.
Why do you say?
Because I'm a boss.
Your mustache fell off.
Let's get set. Go.
How do you feel?
Good.
Good? That really good or just good?
Good.
Hello, I'm the ultimate taxi racer. And I'm the I control this. And if you want to ride, just call a taxi.
Okay. Well, that was a very interesting race, and Gag really put up a lot of hype for it. But Evie has a very interesting friend with her today. Evie?
Here I have with me today is Quasimoto. Quasimoto?
Yes, I am the Hunchback of Notre Dame.
Today, we went actually to Paris, to Notre Dame, and Quasimoto took us through his day in the life as the Hunchback of Notre Dame, and we have a clip to prove it. Anything else you'd like to say before we roll the clip?
Good luck.
Okay.
Roll the
clip. Hello. Today I have traveled all the way out to the capital of France to visit my dear friend Quasimodo at the Notre Dame Cathedral. Quasimodo, are you going to take us on a tour of this magnificent place?
Yes. First off, this is my kitchen. This is where I cook all my meals that I steal from the kitchen. This is where I do my sleeping on this glorious couch. That's just some junk I picked up. And in here, this is whenever the weather gets really cold and where I ring the bells. Yes, it's very dirty, don't get many visitors. Up here is where I stop the people who enter the cathedral. And this is a bell. Look who's coming in now, a terrorist to shoot up the place again.
And that actually feels really good.
Ow! I saw that!
So we're back in here, and this is where I write all the excuses for all my lawsuits. Right here. Yeah. I get in a lot of lawsuits, well, because people actually find out that I've stalked them. Any questions?
Yes. Do you actually worship at this cathedral?
Sometimes. Not all the time. But don't tell the priest.
Okay. Is there anything else you want to show us?
Well, over there, that blue thingy is the pole. I rarely ever use it unless the cathedral accidentally caught on fire, so...
So you never need it?
I never need it.
Okay.
Do you smell that?
What?
Smells like something's burning.
I think you're imagining things. Thank you very much. Back to you in the studio.
Yeet.
Well, Evie, I'm glad you went and saw the Hunchback. How was your trip?
It was great. I will take a free trip to Paris any day.
Yeah, I was in Paris too. I was hunting.
What were you hunting?
That's classified. Anyway, Gage, do you have anything to say about Paris?
Yes. Well, y'all are over there. Y'all turned into a bunch of Parisites. I'm a dad already, guys.
I just got it. Parasite.
It's Memorial Day, and you know what that means? Watermelons. Everybody loves a good watermelon. Evie, you got some information on that?
Yes, I do. So apparently a global epidemic is happening right now, as all of the watermelon farmers in America are becoming freakishly rich, and they don't know what to do with themselves. And so they're celebrating in very odd ways.
Roll the clip.
Bang. Hun here just started.
As you saw, we did some cool stuff and a little bit funny stuff about the watermelon farmers, but there's actually a lot to Memorial Day, and it's actually a really good time to be with your family and just celebrate those people who died for our freedom. And so happy Memorial Day. I hope you ate some lots of ice cream and watermelon with your family and spent some good quality time.
In my hand, my snow up against the burning sand, probably getting gorgeously tanned in summer. I'll finally see a summer breeze blow away a winter storm and find out what happens to solid water when it gets warm.
We have breaking news. We just found a conservative that thinks the apocalypse is about to happen and that the world is about to end.
Would you please roll the clip?
What's your name?
Hi, I'm Robert E. Lee III, and I'm a strict conservative.
And I have been getting ready for the apocalypse for many years. Not just the zombie apocalypse, though, but the middleman apocalypse, the sun dying apocalypse, the grassman apocalypse, the trees dying apocalypse, the rockman apocalypse, and most importantly, the liberal apocalypse. As you can see, I am all jacked out. I got a clip right here, an extra one down here. And I got my big guns always set on automatic so I can just tear those people down. Then I got some extra bullets over here. And I got some tiny gun down here. And in 236 places hidden in my house, I have another clip of bullets. You can never be too careful. And in here, I got my bunker. I got, you know, all the stuff I can use right now. Then over here, if you'll come in, I got all my preservatives. This will last me about 10 years. Then I have the most prized possession in this entire house, my Vienna sausages. Those things will save my life. There, I got some water over here and some Coca-Cola because, man, these things have some unnatural preservatives, so many unnatural preservatives that these things will last for eternity. Just saying. Very unhealthy. And I say it's very, very decorated, very prettily, because that's how my grandma did it. She instilled all of everything that I know into me. She fell into the peanut grinder at the factory. Rest in pieces, Grandma. Rest in pieces. Okay, well, thanks for watching our first episode of season 3. Whoop, 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 whoop. And it takes place on Memorial Day. Yes. And Evie, would you like to say a few things? Here you go.
Thanks for tuning in.
So today we have some special guests here. Today we'd like to thank Kaylee and Garlic for guest starring in this one. We'd also like to thank Xander for being our official chauffeur behind the scenes. What a great man. Then we have Hutch, who I don't think did anything this entire video.
I was a NASA person.
Oh, right, he got a degree in rockets. And then we have Sawyer, who's the greatest hunchback ever to live.
And got shot in the eyeball.
We have Evie, who is one of the greatest, prettiest faces on the show, and is definitely one of our greatest actors. And then we have L-O-V-E. Vivian, who was the cutest. Anyway, that's weird, I'm her cousin. And then we have Curtis, who is for our random mess that we get into.
He was the winner of the racing.
Yep, and he stole my jacket that I totally did not buy from JCPenney. And then we have special thanks to our lead person, Cece over there, introducing us to every single thing. And then we have Fisher, our big joker over there.
I will.
And then, most importantly, everybody, we have me. So, I did everything. So everybody, please have a great day. Eat your milk. Listen to your mama. Good night.
Woo! Excuse me! I think you're forgetting someone!
Sorry, our wonderful cameraman.
Thank you.
I'd like to give a great thanks to all these sponsors.
Come on down to the number store to get your 1263 for all your 1263 needs, because everybody needs a 1263 some point in their life.
Come get your statue, only $25, and if it's cracked, no refunds.
Come get your free tree with only a $100 shipping, because it's a big tree.
I mean, imagine having to haul that.
Hello, come get your survival kit for $19.99. You have two waters, two Vienna sausages, and one mini gun. No bullets included. Limited time. You can only get it for a limited amount of time because the sun will blow up and we will all die.
Okay, any extra guns not included. And if you die from one of these things that are expired, do not sue us because we are not responsible. Thank you.
Thanks for watching. Now here's the bloopers. Pony, but since you won, you deserve the jacket. Do you want the jacket?
No.
Good choice. It's burning up out here. Well, congratulations.
I'm around.
Curtis.
Don't shoot me!
We find hair extension. I don't mind.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, you're gonna do a Paris.
Anyway, it's Ramon.
The helmet that bites back.
We got some.
It's the most amazing thing I've ever seen.
I want him alone. It's Saturday.
Gage, what's happening with Gage? Sawyer?
Yeah, what's happening with Gage?
Just recently he has married a duck. And after a while, she has finally had eggs.
Two.
And they're expecting twins.
We're holding the baby shower on Monday, and it's going to be a gender reveal.
Wait, it is Monday.
Most likely two ducklings.
Yay!
Right?
Meemaw would kill you if she knew you were using her address.
Okay.
Loser. I'm not a loser, but winner loser.
Buddy, you're a young man, poor cousin. Ah, man. Standing in the streets, gonna be a big man someday. You got blood on your face, you big disgrace. Waving your banner all over the place. Say, we will rock you. We will rock you. I don't know the second verse of this song, cause it's so like the first one. And I got no idea. Whatever the date is, you'll have a great day.
It is
they have like kind of a spiral tip.